And in our top business story, annually, the GCC region has seen a significant growth in its economy, with its GDP reaching up to $1.48 trillion in 2012. It continues to be an attractive investment, a testament to their viable partnership, according to authorities. This is further highlighted in the growing number of participants at the 15th GCC Joint Exhibition, inaugurated by His Highness Sheikh Abdullah bin Salim Al Qasimi, Deputy Ruler of Sharjah. He visited each country pavilion that showcased their wide range of companies, products and services. Running from the 26th to the 30th of May at the Expo Center Sharjah, the event organized by the Ministry of Economy in conjunction with the General Secretariat of the GCC is an ideal platform to display the competitiveness of region-made products. In his welcome speech, His Excellency Sultan bin Said Al Mansouri, UAE Minister of Economy, highlighted some of the achievements of the partnership between Bahrain, Kuwait, Oman, Qatar, Saudi Arabia and the UAE. In total, the GCC's net current account surplus is at $378 billion and with foreign assets of $2.2 trillion.
I think there is a clear development of the trade relationship between the GCC countries. Trade has reached almost $92 billion, an increase of almost 5.5% over the year before, which is 2013 over 2012. Now, with that in mind, of course, this definitely there is a very clear policy from the different representation of the private sector that there is a need also to move more of these goods freely between the UAE and the other GCC countries. Of course, this sort of issues are being worked out, the recent decisions by the customs agreement that it will facilitate the movement of goods between the different GCC countries. We also have seen cooperation in the fields of establishment of businesses around the GCC, the freedom by which the GCC nationals are being given over to establish businesses, trade, industries in different countries. We see, of course, the UAE is benefiting also from that. A large investment coming from different GCC countries, Saudi Arabia, Kuwait, and many others, which in a way also represent a success of UAE as a model, as a business model, as an economic model, by which they are also able to benefit from this kind of environment that we have created here in the UAE.
With a theme made in GCC, the events will run the business forum on the sidelines with a focus on deepening economic integration between the Gulf countries. The exhibition industry is among the most important in the world, with close to 500,000 trade events held every year with a value of over $300 billion. This supports sustainable development and progress, according to the officials, such as the UAE winning the bid to host Expo 2020.
I think, number one, politically, this really positioned the Gulf and the GCC as a safe and stable environment represented by the UAE in this case, because we do not talk about ourselves alone, but we talk about the GCC. This is an indication that hopefully will also assist and help in future also possibly establishment of a new kind of exhibitions or conferences within the GCC, international ones, that they can also deliver, they can do it just like what we have gone through, which is basically trying to get Expo, and we have managed to do that.
Exhibitions in general, usually it's the best place or the best gathering that you can show the products. This one in general, but if you talk about the GCC itself, you know that they have a good relation in export and import in between. And that will help also to show all the businessmen in exhibitions from Emirates or from any other country, to show them what's the new in the products, because every year or every exhibition like this exhibition, you will have at least 20% increase in the trade, and you have increase in the factories and in the industry itself. That will be good opportunity for the companies to provide and to show their products in these kind of exhibitions, and it will support and increase also the trade in between the GCC countries.
Average daily hotel rates in the UAE shot up 10.6% to $283.65 the equivalent to 1,041 dirhams in April, according to the global consulting firm STR Global. Both Abu Dhabi and Dubai experienced double-digit growth in revenue per available room. Abu Dhabi went up 17.2% to $123.30 and Dubai by 12.8% to $248.88, with the occupancy rate in the UAE growing by 4.2% to 82.2%. In 2013, 2.8 million visitors checked into hotels in Abu Dhabi, representing an increase of 18% on the previous year's figure, according to Abu Dhabi Tourism and Culture Authority. In Dubai, more than 11 million people stayed in hotels in 2013, which was up 10.6% on 2012, according to Dubai's Department of Tourism and Commerce Marketing. Dubai is targeting 20 million visitors to the Emirate each year by 2020. Regionally, average daily hotel rates in the Middle East and Africa increased 7.2% to $178.93 in April, according to the data compiled by STR Global. The Middle East and Africa region was among three out of four regions where hotel rates increased in April. The Asia-Pacific region, however, is slowing, according to the report's findings. Disputes relating to major Middle East construction projects decreased in value to $40.9 million in 2013, but remained well above the global average, according to a new report by EC Harris. Although the value of disputes in the region dropped from an average of $65 million in the previous year, the value was still significantly higher than the average of $32.1 million seen globally. The study also revealed that the length of time disputes took to resolve in the region fell to 13.9 months compared to 14.6 months in the previous year. The global average was lower at 11.8 months. The Middle East, along with the US, showcased the longest to resolve compared to Asia, UK and continental Europe. Disputes in continental Europe tended to be resolved the quickest at 6.5 months. EC Harris, a built asset consultancy firm, said it also saw the discrepancy of disputes when involved with joint ventures in the Middle East, showing that 46% ended up in disputes during the year. The findings were published in its fourth annual study into the duration, value, common causes and resolutions of construction disputes across the globe. The report found that construction dispute values were the highest in Asia, at an average of $41.9 million, closely followed by the Middle East at $40.9 million. In the US, disputes valued tripled in value to $34.3 million and also rose in the UK to the highest value since the report started at $27.9 million. According to the report, arbitration was deemed the most popular method of alternative dispute resolution in 2013 in the Middle East, followed up by party-to-party negotiation and expert determination.